back to Jamie Allan Golf. We've got a special guest on the channel today, the one and only, the famous Steve Johnston, PGA. So guys, we're on the fourth tee of Cardrona, and what we're going to discuss is common faults related to driving, and how, when we're coaching, how we see related faults that affect your golf on a daily basis. So we're going to talk about a couple each, and we're going to sort of subscribe to what you need to do to sort of improve that, and then you can watch this video, share it around, and make sure you like it. So Steve, do you want to start first?
Yeah, well, the most common fault I see when coaching driving is swing length, right? So a lot of people take the longer backswing because they're really trying to hit driver miles. Backswing gets long, so a lot of things happen there when the backswing gets long. We've got a lot of collapsing going on. But I don't know why people swing longer with a driver.
Nah.
Is it because it's got graphite shaft and fancy big head and we want to kill it, get as much distance as possible? But it's designed the same as any other club. A nice short swing or controlled swing to control your swing centre is going to be much more efficient.
Yeah, absolutely.
Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I think so.
I mean, there's no... If you watch John Ram?
Yeah, John Ram.
Who else is... Tommy Fleetwood?
Tommy Fleetwood, you've got...
Tony Finau. Back to there with driver, and then from there, body coming through, so they're more efficient for impact.
JB Holmes.
So if you can feel as though you've got a three-quarter backswing, then don't rush the downswing, just feel as though you're three-quarter back and turn through. You're going to get the ball away. It's just trying to shorten that down and prevent so many other problems from trying to get long and hit driver too far.
Yeah, I think so.
What do you think?
I think, I mean, driver's obviously the least lofted club in the bag, so I mean, a lot of, the first kind of fault I see is people kind of tee it down to the low.
All right, yep.
So, I mean, it's teeing it down low is obviously good for an eye because it's slightly shorter. I mean, what tends to happen is people tee the ball low, and if I was to try and hit upland driver, with a tee really low, you're almost going to get a top shot.
You get a lot of, you see when people bring their grips in,
yeah,
the clubs to get repaired, and they look at the sole of their club. Many times this part of the club's worn out because when they're taking, this is exactly what you say, the tee's low,
yeah,
and they're trying to hit up, so they're scudding the back of the club off the ground.
Yeah.
And even if they take practice swing, they strike the ground. Just
yeah,
get that club off the ground.
And I think to maximise, obviously, to get the ball in the air, you have to have the tee really high and you've got to hit up on it. So, I mean, one of the biggest faults I see is when people are dressing the ball, and what can happen is, the stand's really narrow.
Yeah.
What happens from there is they get their, see their zip on their jacket,
mm-hmm,
they get that almost in front of the golf ball because their stance is too narrow, and from there they just pass left, balls right.
Yeah.
So, I mean,
so a way to fix that would be just move right foot out.
Yeah, stand wider, which gets your swing set the same.
Just keep ball position in relation to left foot the same.
Yeah.
They get the right foot out, so it's going to move top of the spine.
Yeah. Yeah.
Shoulder level is going to change, right shoulder is going to be lower than left.
Yeah. So it's
perfect.
Hit one. Almost.
That's
like
too low. Is that too low?
That's too low for me, yeah.
After all that chat, put it back.
See up higher, and from there we're just going to create a little bit of tilt. So
there you go, see a wider stance.
Left oh, shoulder's higher, weight's kind of on my back foot.
Just swing that line of your shoulders.
Yep, absolutely.
Nice and short.
Good. Another fault associated with driving is the club face position at the top of the backswing.
Okay.
So biggest kind of fault I see is when people sort of fan the club open on the way back,
mm-hmm,
to see how the club head kind of goes in, but this stays kind of out.
Mm-hmm.
From there, if I was to return the club back into that position, the ball's going miles right, so the brain always adapts to get the back on track. So what do? We swing over the top.
Yep. To square
which,
face.
To square face, which
yep,
is just going to make the club worse.
So how do you think that?
So I think it's important. Kind of pointing more down the line,
absolutely,
and the kind of the club face matches my spine, and then palm is through as well. So totally,
leaving the face more towards the golf ball, we take it back. So
yeah,
so you're leaving the face more towards the golf ball, which is not going to happen. More of that, less of that.
Yeah. That's not feeling bash.
Go for it. We're all watching this. Club face now. Don't go left.
Don't go left.
shot. And it didn't go in.
Wee bit. Oh, you're right. Good stuff. Excellent.
So guys, a few faults related to driving. Make sure you subscribe to your Steve Johnston.
Steve Johnston PGA.
Steve Johnston PGA YouTube channel. Channel Slime, so make sure you get involved. Subscribe to my channel under Jamie Allan Golf, like the video, share the video around, and follow me on all social media platforms, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook under Jamie Allan Golf. Thanks for watching.